Hello and welcome to the Computer Lab Vids YouTube channel, and in this video I will be showing you how to create a thumbnail at the size of 1280 by 720 using a free program called Paint 3D, which is built into Windows 10. So down into the Windows key, look for your programs, looking for P because these are in alphabetical order. So where are we? MNOP, and then Paint 3D is what we need to open. If you want to just search for it, you can just type in your search box in the bottom. So just start to type Paint. It's not the standard Paint, which is this one. It is Paint 3D, which we're looking at. Click on Paint 3D. It will open it up. Straight away, you're presented with this welcome screen. We need to do a new project. Okay, so I like to have looking on these top menus here. Unless you hover over them, you can't see what they are. If you go to the little three dots in the top right-hand corner, you just click on these, and then it'll put the different names underneath each of these items that we need to use in a second. First thing that we need to do to set our canvas size is make sure that we're all good on the dimensions that YouTube recommends. So YouTube recommends a size of 1280 by 720. We are going to go for that size. You can actually double that if you're looking to do HD thumbnails. So to keep the same proportions, you want to go for 2560 by 1440 if you want to go a bit high resolution, and that can be resized so it's proportionally correct. But we'll go with the 1280 by 720. So over to top menu, click on canvas. Right hand side, it's got resize canvas. Just click the unlock so that unfixes these for a second, so the width and the height don't keep proportionally correct until we've changed and lock it back up. So make sure it's on pixels in this box here. Yours might be set to percent. We need that one on pixels, and then make sure your lock's unlocked. Type in at 1280 and then 720 if you don't have that already. Once you've got the dimensions in, you'll see that the canvas size changes to the size we want. Click the lock key and this locks these both in position to the size that we want. If I go for the 2560 now in this box here, for the width, you'll see that the height corrects to 1440. So it's proportionally correct, and that's how YouTube expects it to be. So again, I'll just change the width to the 1280 by 720. You can have the canvas on or off. I like to have it on so I can see what I'm working on. Or you've got the transparent canvas, which will just leave an outline. So if I tick this toggle box here, you'll see that we're left with an outline of our work area. I'll leave that on so we can see what we're doing. Okay, so that's our canvas set. So we've now got something to work on. The next thing is to put an image or a color on here. I'll just quickly show you how to put this as a color. So sort of a primary color in the background. So we go into the stickers section. We go into the art tools because we're doing this as a primary color first. Now you'll see in the art tools, we've got pens and brushes. So if we want to do a spray paint, I'll just quickly go into these, item here. We're on the spray paint icon there. We pick the color in here, so I'm going to pick the blue. Spray is selected and we can spray. So if you're artistic, you can maybe do something in here and design your thumbnail and then export that. But I'm not very artistic in freehand, so I'm going to just undo that. I'm going to put a base color on. So I'm going to go to fill, pick the color that I want, and let's just go for a red. So my paint can is selected, red is selected, over to my canvas, left click, and it'll fill it with the primary color I've just had. So then I can maybe place some text on the top of here, whatever you want to do. Okay, so I'm just going to undo them a second because I'm just going to show you how to put a picture on. So I'll just push the escape key to come back out the menu select, and then we're going to go into our stickers section. So I'm just avoiding the 3D one at the moment, going to stickers, and then in here I'm going to use the shapes in a minute. I'm going to use that to put our text onto. We have a stickers section with different ones that are supplied by Microsoft. So if I wanted a cloud on top of my red background, I'd select the cloud icon, go over to here, push left click, and I could maybe have a cloud there. And this little icon to the right, you stamp that in position. So I'm going to stamp the cloud there, go across over to this corner, maybe have another cloud there. So you can do this as many times as you want. Obviously, if this was my design, I would do that. So I've stamped it on and then push escape to come back out. And maybe, what's that one, a ninja cat in the middle. So you can have a ninja and then resize it in here and do all sorts of bits and pieces. And stamp that in, push escape to come back out. So that could be my thumbnail. I'm just going to go into a bit more detail though. So I'm just going to undo the bits that I've just done there. I'm going to undo the color as well and go back to the white background. So that's our stickers menu. Then we do have a textures pack. This works in the same way as sort of the stickers. So I'll select gravel over to the left. And if you start placing these in position, I can sort of go full size if I want to have a full gravel background. Or if I want small items, I can push the stamp key here and it stamps it, and then push escape and you'll see it stamped in position. Okay, and then the last one is the file of our choice, a custom sticker. So click on the custom sticker icon and then we're going to add a sticker. So click on the add sticker section. So if you've got a picture that you're using, just pick up the scroll to the file that you need. I've got one that I use quite a lot on a few of my thumbnails, which is this desk template here. So I'm going to pick that one and click open. As soon as I click open, you'll see that it puts it onto our image, and then I can drag it around and drag and resize it. So I'm going to resize it to roughly what we need and maybe have it in a slightly different position. So I'm going to go sort of like that, slightly over, maybe a bit less so it doesn't pixelate as much. So I'm thinking, yeah, that looks good. I'm going to stamp it in position with this little icon to the right. Click on that one and then push the escape key to take me out of that menu. You'll notice as soon as I've done that, it leaves this sticker in our custom stickers section. What it will say is, at this point, if you do close paint and come out of it, the stickers will disappear. It doesn't save them in there for you to come into next time. It only leaves them in there while you're working within this particular section. And then you can add another sticker by pushing on the plus sticker sign. And if I go to my pictures menu, I'm going to add my logo in the corner. So this is a GIF, so it's transparent. So I'm going to add that now. So I've got my branding in and I've got my background in my custom sticker. And that's both done in the add sticker section. So I'm going to go to the stickers again and across to the menu on the left hand side, go to shapes and then the square icon, which is this one here, and then pick that one. And then I don't know, I'm just going to do this freehand. So I'm going to drag the box. This is where some of my text is going to go. So maybe have it there. So you notice it's just an outline box. I haven't done anything. I haven't filled it yet. So I have some options here. I've got a line. I don't want a line, so I want none. And I'm going to fill it with maybe a fluorescent yellow. Stamp it in position and escape to come back out. So that's one of my first boxes. I'm going to have some text in. Maybe I'll have another box. Sort of. And again, this is a design of your choice. So I don't like that. I'm going to go maybe have that one like that one there. Stamp that in position. And then maybe have that one maybe I should have done that a different color. So I'm going to pick the shape again. Drag it to where I want it. Change the color. I think we'll go for not white. Doesn't look really good. Go for a red. So there, stamp it in position and then push escape to get back out. Okay, so now I've got my boxes in that I'm going to put some text in. So then up to the text icon in the top, pick that. There is a 3D text in here. I'm not going to go into there. You can have a play around, but you can design 3D text in here as well. It looks quite good. Just takes a bit of messing around with to get the proportions right and the perspectives right. But I'm going to work with the 2D text just to give you sort of an idea of what you can sort of produce. So then pick the 2D text tool up, and now I'm picking my text type. So I'm going to have this one here. We'll see what it looks like first. I'm going to change my, leave the text as black. So I've got 2D text. That's my font. That's my size. I'll have the size a little bit bigger. Then drag my text area that I want. And then whatever I'm doing in here, put some text in there. Can't really read the font, but for this tutorial it's fine, I think. So just resizing the text box and then hovering on the line until I've got the move cursor and then position it where I want to, and I think, yeah, okay, I'm okay with that. Left click to come off it, and then I'm going to have a bit more text in here, and I think I'll go for a white text in this bottom. So I'm still on the text tool on the top, up to the 2D text on the right, click on that, and then we'll go for a nice bold font underneath. So I'm just looking for something a bit, what about that Magneto, might be a bit too abstract, so I'm just looking for something nice and clean.
We'll leave that and see what that looks like. You'll get the idea once I put this in. So, okay, so that's my text for the bottom, and I'm going to do that in white, I think. So just highlight all the text, select the color at the top, pick white, and then that's all in white. And I'm just going to resize it by hovering my mouse over it, pick the center. Okay, I'm happy with that. Left click off there and it places it in position. So that's my thumbnail looking reasonably okay, I think. And obviously at this point we need to export it so we can put it into YouTube and put it as a custom thumbnail within our YouTube video. So up to the left hand corner, click on the menu icon. In here you've got several different options. What we need to do is do a save as, and we want a 2D JPEG. So we'll go out as 2D JPEG. It says, okay, how do you want to save this? So I'm going to call it test 2. It's going into pictures, so it's going to save here. Click save. And we don't want to write the app just yet. That's our thumbnail created. So now I'm just going to minimize this one now. And I'm going to go into find our thumbnail, drag it in from my other screen, and then open my one I've just created. So that is my thumbnail that I have just created that's now previewing it in Windows. So now when you go into your YouTube, you can go to in your thumbnail creation tool where it sets this, so the default one, your thumbnail upload tool in YouTube, and then just upload it as your custom thumbnail. Okay, so I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, please do give us a like or any comments below, and please do subscribe to my channel. It all helps in producing more videos. Thank you for watching.